A while ago, I got this mouse from Poundland and I love it. All this glows up really bright red. This and this is really good quality for a quid. I love it because of my sweaty hands. I can't use touchscreen technology very well. Really, really annoying. Anyway, let's move on to the remote. It's a huge 10-in-1 remote control. 10-in-1, that's 10p for every function. Because this, the amplifier, the remote on it, the volume button broke and it doesn't go up or down anymore. So for, oh well, for a pound, if it works, it works. And in the box, obviously, you get the remote. And you get two sets of instructions. Now, there's this one here. This is telling you how to use it. More on this in a minute. There's like two languages, I think. Yeah, two languages. And then you get this mammoth, and this was folded differently because it is impossible to fold it back to how it was. It just goes on and on and on and on, and these are all the codes for the remote controls. And it's double-sided! There's loads of them, absolutely loads of them. Now, let's get that out of the way. This is huge, by the way. You can't get the scale of this. This is like about three A4 sheets put next to each other. That's a lot of tree. So, anyway, this, the brand is Onkyo. I don't know how to pronounce that. I probably said it wrong. And could I find that on the massive list? Yes! But only two codes out of all of this. I mean, it is helpfully put in, the brands are put in. But it's not for amplifiers, it's for something else. I think it's for a hi-fi. But fortunately, it turns on, which is great. And the volume works, which is great. I mean, why am I using that remote? I'm such a div, aren't I? Yeah, the on-off clearly still works for that. So, what I'll put it on though, because there's 8 buttons, I'll put it on TNT, because I don't know what TNT stands for, but I just thought pressing a TNT button and pressing on, I can pretend I'm pressing detonate, so detonate. So, yeah, that's on. But when I want to press volume down, it actually goes up. I should like zoom in actually, I should zoom in, shouldn't I? Let's zoom in. When I'm pressing down, it's actually going up, and likewise, when I do it the opposite way around. Hey ho, it still works, I don't mind. That's all we really wanted was the volume to be remote controlled again. None of the functions work at all, so how lucky is that? So lucky. Now, the TV part, the TV is made by Pioneer, and none of the codes for anything made by Pioneer worked in this. Not one. And there must have been about 30 different codes for Pioneer in this double-sided, very tiny writing. I mean, look how tiny that writing is. None of it worked. So, there's a function to sort that out. And what you have to do is, you press what function you want to work. So in my case, it was the TV. So you press TV, and you held it for 3 seconds, and then you just press the power button. Right, this is what gets really annoying. You press the power button, and it does it automatically, which is great. However, when it finds it, it continues to keep going. Now, to stop it, in this annoying instruction book, I can even point it out to you, because the writing's a bit more legible in this one. Auto search code. Blah, 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 blah. Auto code searching. Now, it says, press and hold the device key of the remote, e.g. TV, for 3 seconds, which I did. Then release the device key till the LED indicator stays on. Press power. The remote will send power off on signal to the device every seconds. See, there's the first wrong bit. And the LED indicator will blink at the same time. That was not really clear. When the device, e.g. TV, is powered off, press OK. Except you do not press OK. Or any other device key you want to save the codes, and the remote will quit into the normal mode. Remark, every time entering auto searching, it will begin from the next of the present mode. After a circle searching, you probably mean cycle, the LED indicator will blink twice and quit to normal mode without saving any codes. During the process of searching, press the chut up towards or chut down backward. The LED indicator will blink twice and change searching direction. During the searching process, press any key except OK. It's just told me to press OK. Chut up, chut down, the remote will not make any sense. Well, this does not make any sense. It was so annoying. So what happened was, I had the remote, pressed TV, held it down for 3 seconds. This LED is incredibly bright. Incredibly bright. Let me just show you how bright it is. It's not really going to come across on the camera. That is incredibly bright. It's like laser eye surgery. Anyway, so press it down for 3 seconds. I press the button and it does this little flickery thing. I had no idea what to press because it was not okay. And the TV kept turning off and I was pressing okay. And then I tried pressing other buttons and it wasn't saving, it wasn't turning back on. Never once in this bloody book does it mention the word and the button set. Now that might sound like common sense, but you know, you want to go by the instructions because after all, that is what you're there for. This is the button you press when it finally finds the right code for the telly to get it working. I was so annoyed. I was watching Judge Judy and it kept turning off just as she was making the judgments. It was so frustrating. That aside, it is actually, once you get it working, it is quite good for a pound. It's really light. I mean, when you take it out the box, it's incredibly light. It's 48 grams. It is so light. In fact, that is just, no, it's not 48 grams. Yeah, 48 grams. The batteries actually double the weight because the battery's 24 degrees. Yeah, thanks, Brain. The batteries are 24 degrees. The batteries are 24 grams. Two AAA batteries is 24 grams. And so that doubles the weight of this. Well, no, it doesn't put a third. No, doubles. Oh, I'm no mathematician, but you get what I'm saying, don't you? It's really, really light. And I finally got it to turn the TV on and off and up and down and to change channels and just to get the amplifier working, except it won't turn off. I have tried everything. Look, I press a TNT button. There we are, laser eye surgery. It won't turn off. It won't turn off. So I still had to use this to turn it off. But for a pound and the annoying wrong instructions, they were so wrong. I was so angry. It took forever to get it doing. But it's actually really, really good. So now I've only got one remote really to focus on. And then the only time you need to turn this off really is probably when you're going to bed. And that's that. The only thing I've not got tuned into it yet is the TV Onyx Digitybox. Oh, my brain is working top form today, innit? So let's see if it's got TV Onyx on here, because I bet it hasn't. So let's get this massively long thing, and I think it's time to cut because you don't want to see me going crazy trying to find TV Onyx. And of course it isn't on there at all. Now you might be thinking, well, that's your fault for having such an obscure branded product. But as you flick through this, there's some really obscure brands that have gone into administration and long been taken over and booted away. And you're thinking, is that technology even working? I mean, they've even got, on the TV bit, they've even got Fidelity. Now, the Fidelity TV brand, all I can remember of Fidelity, it was that big, massive, fat-back telly that used to be wheeled in when it was at nursery. I don't know why I remember the brand name of that telly. Might not be nursery, might have been reception class or year one at primary school. But I remember Fidelity being written on the telly. A big, long word. And I was just like, well, I don't know anything, I just remember that brand name. But I'm pretty sure they don't make TVs anymore. And And what's this one I've just found? Simtel. Singer. Singer don't make tellies, they make sewing machines. There's loads of obscure brands in here. Maybe they're international, I don't know. I mean, for all I know, maybe Fidelity is a massive brand in America or something. I don't know. Anyway, it's for a quid, it's done what I wanted. And what more can you say? And I've only used 20 pence worth of the buttons, of the functions, haven't I? I've still got all these. Imagine it says 10 functions. So why isn't it 8 functions? Let's have a look at that. Why does it say 10? 10 in one remote control. Let's read the back, shall we? 10 in one remote control. Universal design compatible with most brands and models. Except these. It requires 2 AAA batteries, not included, compatible with Sky. Sky is a trademark of B-Sky B. Yeah, it didn't say anything about, I wonder why they call it 10 functions then, when it's clearly only 8. Universal remote. Operate TV 1 VCR. Audio HDTV. Oh, you can program 2 TVs in then, maybe. Maybe that's what it is. It's funny because it's jokes. Right, reserved to improve specification without notify. Yeah, I think that's meant to say the right is reserved to improve or change specifications without notification. Not notify. Yeah, I think this has been like, oh, I don't know, translated through like several different languages before it got to English because it doesn't make any sense. Anyway, this video is very long now for a pound remote, but should you buy it? Well, I think I'm reasonably happy with it. I mean, I don't want anything more from it. It's done its job. I wanted something to do that. I think it was lucky. Just plain luck. I managed to get just the volume working for that. And the TV was going to be useful to get that working as well, and it does. So, yeah, I am happy with it. The brand is Signalex, but the remote itself is unbranded. So, I think it is just another Pound Shop brand thing. But this is just, yeah. Anyway, that's enough rabbiting on. What do you think? Please, crass. See you when I see ya. Thanks for watching. Bye.